China's dominance in the rare earth sector is not a recent phenomenon. It dates back to the 1980s, when China began to exploit its abundant and low-cost resources and to undercut the prices of other producers, such as the United States, Australia, and Japan. China also benefited from the lax environmental and labor standards, which allowed it to operate with minimal regulations and oversight. China's rare earths output grew steadily over the years, reaching a peak of 135,000 tons in 2009. Since then, China has implemented some measures to control its production and exports, such as imposing quotas, tariffs, and taxes to protect its resources, environment, and market share. In 2023, China produced a total of 240,000 tons of earths, which increased from the year's output of 210,000 tons. Beijing had raised its quotas in the year. One of the countries that has the world's second largest reserves of rare earths, estimated at around 22 million tons, is Vietnam. Vietnam also has a rich history and experience in rare earths mining and processing, dating back to the French colonial era. Vietnam's largest and most promising rare earths mine is the Dong Pao mine, located in the Lai Châu province, near the border with China. The Dong Pao mine has an estimated resource of 7 million tons of rare earths oxide equivalent and a potential output of 20,000 to 60,000 tons per year. However, Vietnam's rare earth sector has also faced some difficulties and setbacks, especially in recent years. Despite its abundant and high-quality resources, Vietnam's rare earths output has been very low and inconsistent due to the lack of investment, technology, infrastructure, and market access. Vietnam's production of rare earths decreased from 4,300 tons in 2021 to just 1,200 tons in 2022, according to the U.S. Geological Survey. In 2023, Vietnam's output of rare earths fell even more to just 600 tons, in spite of its ambitions to increase exports and manufacturing. Vietnam's rare earth sector also suffered a major blow in October 2023, when the Vietnamese authorities arrested several executives of a prominent Vietnam rare earth firm. The executives were accused of illegal trading, tax evasion, and money laundering involving millions of dollars of rare earths products. The arrests also affected the partnerships that the firm had established with some foreign companies, such as Australian Strategic Materials and Blackstone Minerals, to develop and supply rare earths from Vietnam. Despite these challenges, Vietnam still has a lot of potential and opportunities for rare earths, especially in the context of the global demand and competition for rare earths, and the green transition to a low-carbon economy. Vietnam has received some support and cooperation from other countries, such as the United States, which has agreed to boost its collaboration on rare earths with Vietnam as part of its strategy to diversify its rare earth sources and to counter China's influence. Vietnam has also planned to launch some new tenders for mining concessions at the Dong Pao mine and to attract more investment and technology from foreign companies, such as Blackstone Minerals and Linus Corporation. China's rare earths dominance has also raised some concerns and challenges for the rest of the world, especially for the major consumers and importers of rare earths, such as the United States, the European Union, and Japan. These countries rely on China for most of their rare earths needs and are vulnerable to China's supply disruptions, price fluctuations, and political pressures. China has shown its willingness to use its rare earths as a bargaining chip or even a weapon in its trade disputes and diplomatic conflicts. For example, in 2010, China suspended its rare earths exports to Japan amid a territorial dispute over the Senkaku Islands. In 2019, China threatened to cut off its rare earths exports to the United States amid the escalating trade war between the two countries. To reduce their dependence on China and to secure their access to rare earths, other countries have been seeking alternative sources and strategies for rare earths. Some of these include developing their own domestic mining and processing capabilities, such as the Linus mine in Australia, the Mountain Pass mine in the United States, and the Kvanefjeld mine in Greenland. Some also include diversifying their import sources, such as from Myanmar, Brazil, and Vietnam. as well as include increasing their recycling and substitution efforts, such as by recovering rare earths from electronic waste or by using other materials to replace rare earths in some applications. Remember to take a moment to subscribe.